Hello everyone, I'm Rot Rave, and welcome back to Joe Dever's Lone Wolf. Last time we left off, we just dropped a giant chains and hooks on some Gax and Drakkar. And now we've injured and wounded quite a few of them. And we're about to jump into a fight and test out what dual wielding these two maces can do. I still keep the blocking. Oh, it's perfect. And they have bleed. It's a permanent bleed, too, for this fight. It's the best part. What about damage? Alright. It does decent damage. That was really good, actually. He gave me a bleed. Well, let's call our trusty little wolf. And now, Drakkar friend is dead. Mid-strike. Dead. Well, at least it looks like these maces kind of worked out for us. And I still got the blocking ability. That's what's important. I can just do that with more damage. So that's good. That actually will be useful. I guess I'll just use my only healing. My only potion I have that can heal me. Let's use that. But per second for 10 seconds. So that's what, 1500? Yeah, I think a 1500 is better. We have plenty of crossbow bolts, so we're good on that one. A loud cheer from the tunnel echoes throughout the hall. The villagers have witnessed your victory, and they are filled with renewed hope. Their liege lord, Lone Wolf, has come to save them. The first villagers you meet are a dozen miners, all badly bruised and bandaged. They are armed with mining tools they have used to keep the Gax at bay. You commend their bravery, and they give you a proud salute. As you approach a wider section of the tunnel, you see Leandra. She is attending to some refugees. She looks at you over her shoulder. Her eyes fill with tears. She gets to her feet and wipes away her tears on the sleeves of her leather tunic. Leandra does not want you to see her in this state, but it is clear that she is deeply troubled. The Gax have captured my father, she says, trying hard not to let her voice tremble. They will torture him. I know they will. He can be as stubborn as an old mule, and he surely put up a fight, but they are merciless, and they will make him talk. Take heart, Leandra. All is not yet lost, you reply reassuringly. You are wrong, she says. She looks at the ground and clenches her fist. She shakes her head slowly from side to side and says, You just don't understand. Well, enlighten me, if you will, you reply. The angel lifts her head and looks directly into your eyes. You know that my father is Jan Radalian, the famous inventor. His knowledge and skill would be of... I can't speak tonight, so I'm probably going to fuck the word up, even though I shouldn't. Incalculable value to the Dark Lords. Dark Lords of Hell Dodge. Even if he tells them nothing, he is carrying his black book. It contains all his designs, his plans, and processes. The text is encoded, but it is a simple code. The Dark Lords would break it before too long. A cold shiver runs the length of your spine. If the Dark Lords learn the secret of Gen steam-powered engines, they will surely use this knowledge to construct engines of war, at least upon Summerland. It is vital that Gen and his Black Book are found and saved before Leandra's father is carried off to the Darklands. I give you my word. As your liege lord, and as a Kai, I will find and set you free, your father. The Dark Lords will not have him, nor will they learn of the secrets of his process. Nor will they learn of the secrets he possesses. Leandra nods her head. She is close to being overcome with emotion. Abruptly, she steels her nerves and turns to the villagers bravely. She tries to comfort them, despite her anguish. Her father is polite. You're about to set forward to console Leandra, when one of the mine's foreman pushes between you. His head is bandaged and heavily bloodstained around his right ear. He lost his ear to a cat blade. Excitedly, he insists on telling you how grateful the villagers are that you have come to save them. They have all listened to your conversation with Leandra, and they understand the gravity of the situation. Selflessly, they resolve to help you, their liege lord, in any way they can. They tell you that the forest is vast, and it will be invaluable to have a safe outpost for you to fall back into if the going gets rough, too rough. The miners speak of emergency supplies they have shared. They can share them. They inform you that there is also a forge that can be used to repair your gear if it needs be. You thank them for the valuable help before you head for the exit. You must pursue the Gax and their captured prisoner without delay. They will have covered a lot of ground by now, but they will also have left a trail. You must catch up with them as quickly as possible. My lord, the enemy still holds the main tunnel entrance, says the foreman. But there is another way out of the mines. I will show you. You bid the villagers good luck and farewell. Then you follow the foreman along the adjoining passageway that leads to the vertical mine shaft, wherein an iron pattern bolted to the wall of the shaft ascends to several tunnel levels above. You climb after the miner until you reach a small. Unlit chamber. Here he pulls a concealed lever and a hidden portal grinds open. Moonlight streams through the widened gap and a gust of freezing air rushes and chills your face. The secondary exit was excavated in the side of the rocky formation to provide a way to escape in case of an emergency. You now stand in a narrow cliffside rocky platform, overhanging a small clearing several feet above the canopy of the sunken forest. The trail you took previously now lies to your left. The miners could have tried to escape this way, but it is unlikely that they would have knowingly risked facing Gax out in the open. Now they will have to fight and defeat the ones who remain in the tunnels. If they are to secure the main entrance, it goes against your strongest sense of duty to leave your people to face this daunting task on their own. But you know you must go. Look there, my lord, whispers the foreman, pointing to the to a part of the cliff facing where it is less steep. You realize that from there you will be able to reach the ground and finally give chase to Jen's captors. You decide to heed the foreman's advice, and you thank him for his help. You also tell him that you must go it alone from this point. It's too dangerous for the brave, but wounded men to accompany you any further. You thank the old miner, dismissing him. You begin to climb back down the cliff, but as you're doing so, you're alerted by a noise of crunching snow and the ominous rustle of foliage. Fearful that another assault is about to take place, you rush for trees in search of the approaching enemy. The tunnels must not be occupied again. You're looking for the enemy when a patrol suddenly emerges from the darkness. They see you, and they fall upon you in an instant. They all have their weapons drawn, and they glare at you with hatred blazing in their evil eyes. Alright. This ought to be fun. Only two? That's not patrol. They have the advantage on me. This is not good. They don't want to attack me first. Oh, fuck. I need to heal. Useful. I don't need it right now. Alright, we're just gonna skip this part because we know what happened. restart the fight. I'm just gonna try to rethink the strategy. God, the RNG was on my side, because there is a slight chance of me being able to dodge their attacks without having to use the guard. It's a very slight chance to happen, but when it does, it's so fucking useful. You don't get to attack at all. You stay stuck for a bit. He was meant to attack so quick. Same situation happened again. Please give me a healing item. Damn it, they didn't. Did they get a new ring? Don't know what does his rings have right now. Does this have any kind of effect? Plus one percent for critting, and then my intelligence. Give me a plus one dexterity. You give me a plus two dexterity. Well, I think it's best I keep the dexterity on, right? You enter the densely packed pine trees, leaving the bodies of your slain enemies strewn around the clearing. Behind you, the trail left by the cart is easy to spot, and determinedly, you head west through the freezing forest. I don't have any heal items, but the mine is a shop, so yeah, going to definitely talk with the merchant. What's the MC do? You don't do shit compared to the maces I currently have. The only healing item he has is that can't be the only one. Oh, thank God. So, the shield. This is a plus three. I feel like I can do more base damage with it. Okay, let's do it. Sound. X actually just need like one more piece of steel and I can max this out. Sword user. Oh wait. There's a mason. And his base attack for this is way lower than this sword up here. Alright. Like if I'm thinking this correctly, then first like the let's take a look at this real quick. Okay, so it only increases by 5 each time. Okay. Alright, yeah, I'm gonna sell that back to him. First. Steel superior letter. Well, let's at least max out that durability. Maybe later I will upgrade it again. Alright, let's go to my gear. Stat concerns are base damage wise, this one's obviously better, but like stat wise, I do probably more base damage having this on because it gives me increased strength. That's my thinking, at least, on it. I could be completely wrong. Alright, we're now equipped. We have more heals. We need to get sorry enough to get camp. The old track continues into the forest, but soon all traces of it disappears beneath the snow-covered foliage. Resolutely, you push through the trees until you are brought to a halt by the faint aroma of wood smoke. You sniff the cold air and detect another smell that you can recognize immediately. The unpleasant scent of Gex. With renewed caution, you advance through the forest, your senses alert to the close proximity of the enemy soldiers. Trees thin out and you glimpse the flickers of flames in the middle distance. Instinctively, you take cover amongst the foliage and focus your sharp eyes on the flames and their immediate surroundings. You can see a small campfire, which has been lit in the middle of dry forest trail. Around the fire are several yaks, with piles of loot stolen from the Rockstone, having stopped here to discard and burn items that are of little use. They now appear to be abandoning their makeshift camp in a hurry. Choice pieces that are too heavy to carry, but too valuable to be thrown away, are being loaded with haste onto the front of the rickety wooden wagon. At the back of the wagon stands a large iron cage in which a middle-aged villager is being held prisoner. He sits slumped against the cold iron bars, his graying hair matted with blood that oozes from a wound onto his scalp. His faint, misty exhilarations tell you that he is unconscious but still alive. You are in no doubt this is Leandra's father, Jen Redellion. The Gax will soon be leaving with him. Their valuable loot and prisoner. You must act quickly if you are to save Jen from being transported away. Make a choice. I don't have the cloak skill. Create a diversional in order to approach the wagon unnoticed. Jen needs help and there's not time to lose. You are for the cage to free him. That's just a stupid idea. Create a diversion. I honestly think they could have done something better with that. But I feel like the better choice would have been this one. Choosing to know how to master the discipline. Just scrape away the snow near your feet and uncover an apple-sized chunk of rock. Then, with calculated precision, you hurl the rock high into the air. It arcs through a gap in the trees and lands with a loud thud on the forest trail, several yards ahead of the wagon. Startled by the sudden noise, the Gax draw their hand weapons and rush to investigate. The moment they leave the wagon attended you, emerge from the trees and sneak around to the rear, crouching low to stay hidden from sight. Carefully remove the lock peg and lower the wagon's worm-eaten tailgate. Jen has suffered a severe beating at the hands of the cruel Gax. He is unconscious and buried alive. If he remains locked in the iron cage with his head bleeding and his body exposed to the freezing cold, he will surely perish before the night is over. The door of the cage is kept secure by a crude lock, and you feel confident you can open it without too much trouble. Unfortunately, before you are able to pick it and rescue Jen, trouble comes and pays you an unwelcome visit. Gis, Ak, Titsa, Tekzek, enemy of the wagon tail, shrieks a yak on the forest trail. Its cry alerts others, and they come rushing towards the wagon with their weapons held, ready to strike. You are forced to abandon the lock and leap down from the tailgate to meet their determined attack. This should be an easy fight. From the sounds of it, just Gax in general. In comparison to other fights that we've had. So you're the one that alerted everyone to my position, huh? Well, you can do this. Fuck you. Alright. So we start this. Grease out of the reflex. Okay. It's actually pretty useful. Definitely gonna have to heal, apparently. Why can't I heal? Because they just immediately attack to attack. Yeah. I'm definitely gonna have to heal. I do not have the... technically, I guess it's better for that to happen because... Now it makes more sense for a wolf to appear. Lock up. so useful. It's 4 gex so far. He's almost dead, so I'm gonna probably take out the wind. Moon, are you down? You're almost dead, buddy. By the looks of it, you're gonna die. It does feel like I did a little bit more damage, at least. Alright, what do we get from this? Stamina replenishing, pine, steel, and superior letter. Okay, that's not bad. Gold. Having dealt with your enemies, your concern now is to release Chen from the iron cage as fast as possible. But as you turn to, on your heel, your heart sinks. The wagon has disappeared. It was hauled away by a gang of Gaks during your fierce combat. All that remains are set of fresh wheel tracks in the snow that blanket the forest. Okay, that's just not cool, man. Oh well. I just get a feeling this is gonna be one hell of a chase, and we're only gonna end up actually getting caught up to them. Later. Well, I think I wasted that damn Kai potion. Oh well. Let me look at something real quick. Gandalf. location for an unknown enemy. This ought to be interesting. You set off along the trail at a run, following the imprints left by the wheels of the wagon. Between these parallel tracks, you can see many fresh footprints. From the size and number of these prints, you deduce that the heavy wagon's been hauled by 6 Gex. It cannot have gone very far, and you are confident that you can outpace them. The trail snakes through the forest before it arrives at a small clearing. Here, you catch sight of the wagon. The Gex have been spotted by a patrol of armored Drakkarim, who are policing the transportation of the stolen loot. From Roxton, one of them sees you enter the clearing and raises the alarm.
Ekdolk. Look, enemy scout. Get him.
As the Drakkarim come striding towards you, one of their number orders of the Gak wagon team to leave the clearing at once.
Deza Ondak Ek Boka Na Dos Eza Togok. Pull the wagon to our camp quickly.
Okay, so am I just fighting 2 Drakkarim? Or what? 2 Drakkarim or 3?
It's just 2. I could definitely handle 2. It's just this new power. Got the crit on 1, not on the other. That's not good. Should be dead from this. There we go. Was that necessary? Probably not. Was it fun? Yeah. I always love how the draw out fadeaways they have. Pretty cool. Oh, thank God. More heals. Thank God. Having dispatched the Drakkarim, you waste no time chasing after the wagon. The Gex cannot have hauled it very far, and you're determined to catch up with them. You leave the clearing and race along the moonlit forest trail, following with ease the tracks left by the fleeing Gex in the heavy wagon. The trail winds through frozen trees and descends a gradual slope towards an open area where the pines have recently been chopped down. You see the wagon and its team at the bottom of the shallow decline. They are laboring hard to pull their load towards the cluster of Drakkarim tents that have been erected in the middle of this cleared timberland. One of the Gex leaves to the others and scurries towards the largest tent to report your ambush. The remaining Gex haul the wagon into the middle of the clearing and bring it to halt. With weapons in hand, they form a semicircle at the rear of the wagon and stand guard over their cage prisoner. They are determined not to be taken surprised a second time. Oh, can we... My master of animal kinship lets you call in a wild beast of the forest for help. You know, that's what I'm doing. Fuck everything else, that's gonna be a fun one. Quickly, you leave the trail and take a cover among the trees surrounding the encampment. The gags at the rear of the wagon are highly fearful and alert. Their fearful eyes scour the perimeter for the slightest sight or sound of your approach. A soft rustle of branches and a fall of loose snow from a nearby treetop is enough to make them whimper and cower with fright. You look to the canopy of pines of the place from where the loose snow fell, and you see a great number of bats hanging beneath the upper branches. Using your Kai discipline of animal kinship, you transmit a strong mental command to these bats, compelling them to leave the tree and swoop down on the enemy sentries. As one, the bats respond with swift and impressive effect. The gags are quickly engulfed by a squeaking, swirling cloud of bats that nip and swat them repeatedly. While the guards are distracted by this bat attack, you leave the trees and run to the tree stump inside the clearing. Here you take cover and fire your ranged weapons, wounding some of the gags. Your volley of missiles causes the bats to abandon their attack. As the colony returns to their perches in the snowy treetops, you advance towards the unsteady sentries with your hand weapon raised in readiness to cut them down. Okay, so there's only 5 gags in this part, from what I understand. Automatically heals me. And right now, I don't use that kind of discipline too much. But before we get to this fight, I end the video. Hope you guys are enjoying the series. I certainly am. The story is really awesome. This is one of my favorite story play games, honestly. Hope you all are enjoying this as much as I am. Hope to see you all in the next video. I hope you all have a good day. Midnight. I'll see you next time.